Good morning, St. Monica Academy. Let's begin in prayer. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum. Fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii, Spiritus Sancti. Well, this morning assembly is a little bit late in coming, but we prepared something kind of special for you. We want to share with you what your teachers were doing over spring break. I think you'll be very impressed. We begin with Mr. Bradley, who escaped to the desert to get in touch with his sensitive side with this beautiful picture taken from God's country. Mrs. Brewer found her John Paul the Great scarf and decided to start a Catholic biker gang called Heaven's Angels. Miss Curry was slightly in denial that Disneyland is actually closed and did her best to make her dreams reality. Mrs. Lessard wouldn't let See's candy store's closing stop her, so she just made her own chocolate for Easter. Mrs. Morellis had her sons take all of their broken skateboards and built this wonderful outdoor bench. Mr. Plants built a new desk for his home office and got to show off how many books he has, winning the Nerd Award for spring break this year. Mr. Quackenbush and Mr. Shalmutzy continued raising their chickens in an attempt to live off the grid. Mr. Shalmutzy assures me all the chickens are still alive. Mr. Fryman, proving he can do anything, built a foundation for a small back house on his property, putting all of his fellow teachers to shame, except for one. I spent spring break making this, the Roloflex 10,000. Constructed of pine or perhaps Nordic cherry, this feat of engineering can support the weight of even the heaviest industrial toilet paper roll. As you can see, it is clearly the greatest thing ever made by human hands. Pretty impressive, right? That, of course, is only a small sample of the many talents that all of your teachers have. Really, just the ones who got back to me. But you know what? If you send me your pictures, you get featured in the morning assembly. So if you didn't make it, it's your own fault. Before we go today, I want to talk a little bit about the virtue of courage. Now, many, if not all of you, know that courage is not the absence of fear. Courage is doing what we ought to do, fulfilling our duties despite fear. It means not letting fear paralyze us. It also means being responsible and prudent, not pretending like there are no dangers around us or no challenges. So courage, really, I think, is a key virtue for us in these times right now. So pray about that. Pray to your guardian angel, pray to your patron saint, pray to Christ to infuse us more fully with courage as we proceed through these challenging times. Remember that for those of us who follow Christ, we know that in the end, he wins, no matter what sacrifices, what suffering might come before that time. But right now, as we go from day to day, and we try and do the best we can, let's all ask for courage. Let's seek it out. Let's practice it. Let's make it stronger in our lives. Please stand for the code of conduct. I show my love for God in all I say and do. I am ready to serve others. I treat people with charity, justice, and respect. I work with honesty, excellence, and perseverance. I glorify God in my appearance, manners, and speech. Go and be courageous today.